cast out that. Oh, don't have, you know, okay, this is the worthy, okay. Let's put this worthy before God and let's get our dreams fulfilled. Let's get our needs fulfilled. Yeah, this one is part of prayer. But I don't think they do all these things. Because he got whatever his father provided. He didn't have to ask God, Dad, give me some food to eat. He didn't go, Dad, okay, I'm going to get scared of some demons, Dad, I want a protection. He didn't say all these things. He said, Dad, I want to intercede for a nation, Dad. He didn't say, oh, I want to intercede for somebody. He didn't say, God, Dad, I want to confess my sins, or I want to confess something. He didn't say all these things. So you might ask, what is prayer then? Okay, Adam did not do all these things. Just imagine, Adam did not do all these things. But the Bible says, it's a prayer, it's a communication. God came to speak to him. God made the initiative to speak to him. You might be saying, okay, prayer is all these things, so confessing sins, and only casting demons, and healing, and doing all these things. You might be thinking prayer. But Adam did none of these things. If at all he had to intercede, it was only for his wife, and he didn't have anybody to intercede. Only for his wife, he didn't have. How much I mean, intercede for his wife? Because his wife was always with him. My wife was just near him, so I don't know how much time he intercede. And then nothing to do. You know, you just imagine the life in God and Adam. I tell you how was life in God and Adam. You know, God said for Adam one thing. Have dominion. God said have dominion, rule this earth, subdue it, be fruitful, be multiplied. The five things I can know about the word of God very clearly what God said. So as Adam and God used to walk every day in the garden, God said for Adam, have dominion over the station, have dominion. So Adam and Adam asked God the Father, what's the meaning of dominion? So what is dominion? God will say, see, you know the giraffe, you know the elephant, they're so big. If they come to attack, you can't do anything. They're so huge. But you can do something. Have dominion, you can have control. So Adam and Adam, how can I have control over this thing? God will say him very clearly, by the word of your mouth. Just speak and they will stop. If you command them, they will listen to you because I have given you the dominion. So God, Adam and Adam, this is a voice of confession between God and Adam. So Adam and Adam, how to rule this earth? How to rule this earth? God might have saying for him, you enjoy the garden. Always tend the garden, always plant the garden, or so you not plant the garden. Make the garden look very green, very, very fresh. If any animal comes to the garden, you have to put it straight. If any animal does something wrong, you have to put it straight. Whatever you come on this earth, it will happen. This is what God told Adam. Now the main thing which God must have, this imagine is some of the glimpse which I feel. God must have speak to Adam. Do this, do that, do this, do that. You know, Adam would have not got anything. You know, whenever animal, a big, huge animal, elephant came in front of Adam. Adam did not say, God, oh God, so such a big animal is going to come, God, that wanted to. God told him, I am giving you the dominion. By your words, you speak to the elephant, will stop in front of you. Speak to the lion, he will stop in front of you. Speak to any animal, any bird, any creatures, any reptile, anything, they will obey you. Because I have given you something. I have given my image. I have given you the dominion. I have given you the power to rule. I have given you to subdue. I have given you something to take over it. Take over it. God says, I have given you power to multiply. What do you mean by multiply, God says? You can multiply by putting seeds. God says, the more you plant, the more the seeds are being multiplied. No. Whenever you have a good relationship with your wife, you multiply. This is what God was saying for Adam. Have a good life with your wife and you multiply. Have a good life with your wife and you become fruitful. There are many things. This is what I imagine something. Just imagine the life between God and Adam, the way God is to speak to Adam is to speak to God. This is what was prayer to me. This is what was prayer. You know, prayer is something that is between you and God. You speak to God continually on a continuous basis. It is not every morning you are going into prison. So every morning he is coming to meet you. This is what is prayer. Every morning he comes to meet you. Every morning he came to meet Adam.